You never bring God to your level. You go to God's level. Then you will really understand many things in a better way. There cannot be a prayer. Hey, there cannot be a prayer which cannot be answered. One Samuel chapter 1 verse 10. Hannah was in bitterness of soul. She prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. There was a problem she was going through. She was not successful in certain areas. There were others who were very successful. They were all oppressing her. They were competing with her. She was not competent enough. She was actually bullied by people. Insulted. Many of us, we live with insult and we think this is life. You need to get acquainted with this lady called Hannah. She never took insult as a way of life. She never thought that way. She knew she can change it. Say, change it. If you follow Hannah, you will change. You follow X and Y, then you will become an onlooker. Probably people will pity you. Hannah, she had a bitterness of her soul, prayed to the Lord, wept in anguish. She knew where her help will come from. She knew it is not words. It's her everything. Prayer is not words. God is not interested in your money. He is not interested in your time. He is interested in everything. Your prayer is a reflection. You either pray and give everything, or you just pull back and keep everything. She bitterness of soul, wept in anguish. I don't know what degree it is. And she said, you see, she made a vow. I think she was shouting at God. Vow. What is vow? Vow is not wow. This is different vow. She threw everything to God. She said, you give me, I'll give you. But I want it in my life. You see the mindset she has. That is a vow. A vow is something which empties yourself. That is a vow. In certain religions, they make a vow of giving the hair. It's a shame, especially for women. For women, hair is a glorious thing. Hair is a very important thing. They give away the hair. That's called vow. They shame themselves. That's how religion will do. Religion doesn't mind shaming you. Doesn't mind making you a mockery. But that is how vows are. Vows are like that. This lady made a vow. Not to shave the head, but to give back whatever God gives back to him for his glory. What a vow. That means, so see, I am understanding the degree to which she was emptying herself with God. Today, many of us, we struggle with X and Y, small things. You have not explored the power of prayer. That's all I want to say. Then you go to somebody, you pray for me. Maybe God will hear you. If God cannot hear you, if your father cannot hear you, who will recommend? You come and recommend me to my daddy. I will deal with him. To recommend you to your daddy, why should I? Who am I? Why should people come and pray? When I have no way of exploring prayer myself, what other people's prayer will do for? Tell your neighbor, explore prayer. Please know what is prayer. Prayer is not what people are teaching, what religion is teaching. It's not prayer. Prayer is a heart-to-heart conversation with your father who sent you in the world. You are his disciple. You are his agent in the world, working on his behalf. How can he doesn't listen to you? When I send somebody, I am always asking, where are you? What happened? You met that guy? What he said? Every 5 minutes I call him. That's how it is. When I send somebody to finish my work, I am in touch with you all the time. If God has sent you in the world to finish his work, that means he doesn't hear you. It's ridiculous. What system you are talking about? You are talking about our ration card, a ration shop. Ration shop, in those days, ration card, we don't have sugar. So we go to the ration shop and ask, sugar aa gaya? Haan, nahin aaya. Ja, ja. In those days, when we were all small people, sugar was available only in ration shop. I don't know about Mumbai, it was like that in our city. So sugar, we always bought in ration shop. So we are rationed. Only certain kilos of sugar is given. Hey, God is not a ration shop. God is a universe. He is God. Say God. God is God. Don't behave God. You don't bring God to your level. You go to God's level. You never bring God to your level. You go to God's level. Then you will really understand many things in a better way. There cannot be a prayer. There cannot be a prayer which cannot be answered. If you are struggling with unanswered prayers, I tell you, you are struggling with your understanding about God. You have not explored anything. You are in a place where you have nothing to do with prayer. Maybe you are taking a lot of effort. Lot of effort. But somewhere it's all misfired efforts. It doesn't fire correctly. I want to say to every one of you, if you are discouraged, if you are living in an oppressed situation, I want to say this to you today. God is not God's will for you to live in that place. If you think you are taken advantage of, somebody is exploiting you, you are not in the right place. You should get out. You should get out. And God will help you for that. Only one place, if you are in a marriage, then you wait there and see the will of God. Pastor bol diya. Mere piche mata. I have not said anything like that. I am talking about Hannah. Tell your neighbor, I am learning about Hannah. We are learning. Are you learning something?
Yes.
Hannah made vow. I will give, you give God, you give Samuel, I will give it to him. I will tell you, Samuels will be born in your life. Samuels will be born. Deliverer. Who is a Samuel? He's a guy who sucked God in the world. Nobody was with God. Here is a guy who delivered God to the world. Samuel. Very important guy. Then what happened? Verse 12. She continued praying. I don't know how many hours she was praying and praying and praying and praying. She continued praying before the Lord. Eli watched her mouth. Hannah spoke in her heart. Only her lips moved. But her voice was not. Eli thought she was drunk. Okay, poor guy. Because she was under. When she came in, she was okay. Suddenly she became mad. So he thought she's drunk. Let me tell you something. If prayer is not consuming you, you're not praying. You're not praying. You're just wasting time. And some small victory, either udar, immediate testimony. 5,000 rupiah mil gaya, pastor. Testimony. Are 5 crore dega wo. You are happy with 5,000. Let us not be satisfied with small tidbits. Let us have God in our lives. Let's go further. She is saying, I have poured out my soul before the Lord. I don't know. You know about it? How many ladies in this house? You learn this. You learn this. If you cannot do this, something is wrong with you. Your children may suffer.
Yes.
She said, what she is saying? I poured out my soul. What is this? Soul is a liquid form. I don't know what she did. You need to learn these things. I'll tell you, she got up victoriously. See the end, verse 18. Her face was no longer sad. No longer sad. That's the end of it. She finished her oppression on that day. No longer she carried anything of that. That's it. She ended it. Today, you are a person, you are a child of God. Why are you going through what you are going through? You end it. We have to end it. Why you have to end it? It is not of God. Why it should continue? If it is not of God, why should it continue? Let us not become a victim. If somebody, some devil is giving it to me and my family, why should I bear it? Ask that question. I don't think you should bear what devil is not giving, what God is not giving. She spoke. She poured her soul. I tell you, today victory is yours. Victory is ours. Today whatever hurts your soul, it can hurt your prayer life. Prayer life is suffering because
Your soul is suffering.
Prayer life is all gone away because there is no proper soul. You're not taking care of your soul. Your soul, I told you, it is emotions, mind, and your will. Emotions. How are you emotionally? How are you emotionally? Many of us, we don't have the right emotions. We have the wrong emotions. When you exhibit wrong emotions, how can you pray? You tell me. When your soul is wrong, your prayer is wrong. When you have a wrong emotion, many women, I'll tell you, women are under attack. All the time they have a wrong emotion. Some of them. If you're emotionally not okay, I tell you, you need to repent. You need to change. When your emotions are not right, how can you pray right? Let me tell you the right emotion. Thankfulness is the emotion. When you're not thankful, how many of you are thanking God for what you have now? We all the time, we have complaints. We want this, we want that. We don't appreciate what we have now. Definitely something may not be there in your life. I'll tell you something. Fullness is the kingdom value. Fullness is a kingdom aspect. It's in heaven. Sometimes it is on earth. Don't worry about fullness. Be thankful for what you have already. There are things which may come. Eventually it will come. As the days goes on, it may come. But how much we are thankful to what God has already given us. Thankfulness. When you have a thankful attitude, will there be a complaint? Will there be a... Many people don't receive anything because they are not thankful for what they have already. You have so much which God has given. The greatest realization I come into when I go in the trains, you know. There are some people, one day, one man came without two legs. There was a man who came who was walking like this. How many times we have thanked God for what He has already given us? It's the right emotion, I tell you. When you thank God, you will cry. When you thank God, you will cry. You will burst out crying for what you already have. Today, you have so many things. We have so many things. But we fail to thank Him. Probably some of you may thank God today and tomorrow vapas. Hey, thankfulness is an attitude we need to carry. We need to carry 24 hours, 365 days to keep my emotion right. When I spoil my emotion, I tell you, I spoil my prayer life. If there is one thing which should be spoiled by the devil, it's your prayer life. He's not worried about anything. He's not worried about your money. You spoil your prayer life, you'll spoil your money. He's not worried about your health. Worried about many things. The moment you're emotionally confused, your prayer is over. Your prayer is over. Take care of your soul. Tell your neighbor, take care of your emotions. That's why, you know, emotionally don't get attached with people. Don't bring emotion. All the time, don't bring emotion. Don't bring the emotion inside. You be emotional when you pray. Before you allow people inside your emotion, you be very careful. Because your emotional health is so important for your prayer health. You need to keep your emotions right. Mind. Your mind, I'll tell you something. Your mind is very important for your prayer. Today, many of us, there are so many things which is in our mind. Anything which bring in your mind, which is ruling your mind, is your God. For many people, money is a God. For many people, relationship is God. For many people, you know, there are many, many gods which come. See, anything which is God, which is not God, but plays the role of God, becomes an idol. It's an idol. An idol is something which takes the place of God. It's an idol. Nothing can take the place of God in my life. In my life, God should be God. If I have anything as God, my position, my money, probably what the articles which God has given us. For example, God has given us a lot of things. Sometimes God will give you a Harley Davidson bike, very expensive bike. You like? Tomorrow if God gives you Harley Davidson bike, the moment you make that as your God, you can make it as God. Anything which takes the place of God. Some people for others, I think your house will be your God.
I know a man who was only looking, he built a house, every day he will do.
Good man. But his house is his God. Which is your God? What God you have today? How can you pray? How you will pray when you have no soul? How can you pray? Today many of us, our prayer life is in shambles because we worship different things. Many things have crept into our life. God is God in my life. When I put that first, I tell you, we can pray well. We can pray well. You can pray well when God is God in your life. Then your will work correctly. Then your will get up. Why you are not able to get up in the morning? Your will is weak. Your will is not working, no? When you get up, your will says, then Tuesday, what it will say? Aaj Tuesday. Sunday, what it will say? Aaj to tum sone ka 12 baje tak. Why your will is not working? Because your emotion is not working. Emotion is punctured. Your mind is punctured. Then how will work? Will not work. That is why we suffer in our life. My friends, let me tell you. Devil wants you to suffer. He wants you to... Some people, you know, they... Don't be satisfied with anything less than God. That's all I can tell you. Don't be satisfied with anything less than God. Your prayer life is the key. You have it all or you don't have it all. You change your prayer life. Change the way you pray. Change the way you talk. Change the way you think about God. There cannot be a no from God at any point. Unless it is not right in His sight. You understand? If you are asking for something which is not right, I'll give you one example. There was somebody who was praying for the marriage of somebody because he liked her. He was praying. Good, he came to me after some time. He said, Pastor, I'm praying. I said, stop praying. Because why you want to pray? That she will like you. If she likes you, then you can marry. Otherwise, it's not possible. Are you with me? You cannot just go and twist somebody because you like Bollywood style. No, it is not like that. And all these are, if you have any doubts, come to me. I will help you. Okay? Always you pray the will of God. Never pray like that. Don't pray wrong prayers. Pray the right prayers. I'll tell you, I'll tell you something. Today, God wants to put your prayer life correct. Why God wants you to pray correct? Why God wants your prayer life to be right? So that you can be blessed. Today, when your prayer life is not blessed, you can never be blessed. You just don't waste time running from pillar to post. Whoever you are, it is God's will for you to prosper, to be successful, to go to great heights. Because He has sent you in this world to fit your big vision, to fit into that. So when you don't pray correctly, you don't fit. You don't fit. Many people live and die without fitting into anything. What is the use? I personally know so many people. They have done nothing for God. What is the use? Good people. But eternal point of view, what have you done? I want to ask each one of you. For eternal point of view, you are an eternal spirit. In heaven you will live forever. When you turn back on earth and say what you did on earth,
and if you have nothing to do with eternity, what is this? It's a waste of time, waste of 60-70 years for you to make one decision of knowing God.
I took one decision of knowing God on when I was 19. That's all. After that, there are n number of things we need to do. There are cities we need to build. There are people we need to build. If I cannot handle my home, I cannot handle myself, how can I handle others? Today you need to master yourself. You need to master everything under your authority, so that you can go forward and do bigger things for God.